Mad King's trove is ours.
All just aside, we must tell the people the good news, and I think Liege should be the first. Seconded. There's to be a meeting of representatives from across Almigo, so she is sure to be in the city. Shall we seek her out?
Yes, ma'am, sir, person thing. These, we've got money for you. We've got money for you. Hello, Liz. Lahees.
I swear, something is...
I knew it.
I thought that the audio was quiet. It's been quiet this entire time.
I'm glad
How are you people? I skipped a dialogue back soon.
I'm glad you asked, Liz. I'm pretty sure you're going to like the answer.
I knew the audio was quiet.
You're joking. The Mad King's Trove? I thought it was a myth.
So did plenty of people. But they didn't have Bella and Alpha now in their party. The credit for finding it should really go to them. As for what to do with all of it, I vote that it goes towards alleviating the suffering of Almigo's poor.
Gods, if that there's as much as you say.
Anvel did not exaggerate, I assure you. We could not hope to carry even a fraction of it out on our own. I have taken the liberty of sketching out a rough map of the ruins. You will assemble a squad of your own trusted freedom fighters. They should be able to follow the route to where the treasures lie.
Understood. I'll make sure every coin is accounted for, and that goes for the spending of it. And that goes for the spending of it all as well.
Thank you. Oh, there's one other thing. When the time comes to draw up a plan for distributing the spoils, I would ask that you consult Alpha now. I don't have a head for details. I'm not educated. I see that simply handing out sacks of gil won't solve anything. Everything, but I couldn't rightly tell you what to do instead.
Oh, I know the feeling. I'd welcome any advice you could give us, Alpha now.
Of course. I shall do and be at your disposal.
Commander, we've got a problem! Commander!
Deep breaths. Tell me what happened.
A mob gathered outside headquarters, and they started making demands. You best come and see for yourself.
Commander!
Commander!
Well, fuck. An angry mob already?
Step back, all of you!
Hey, pieces of shit.
Like hells we will! We know who you've got in there!
We're not leaving till you hand her over!
Bring her out! Bring her out!
Who is it?
What's
oh, it's Fordola.
On? Someone let slip about Fordola.
It's true then. The bitch really is in there. I knew it. I bloody knew it. We demand vengeance! Bring her out! Today we butcher the butcher!
Butcher the butcher!
I think she should
come
die.
On, you don't mean that. We'd be no better than the Imperials if you'd all just calm down.
Yeah, calm your tits.
Calm down! That monster and her thrice damned skulls dragged my man from our home and beat him to death in the street!
Okay, maybe she has a reason.
And my dad! That bitch has spilt enough blood to fill a lock!
That's a lot of dead people.
We all know her crimes. She's a traitor and a murderer. How many of your resistance friends have died at her hands, eh? And here you are, protecting her!
That's true. Alizé almost died. She almost killed her.
So that's what all the fuss is about.
Rob on!
Hearken to me, brothers and sisters of Alamigo.
Hey, who's this?
It's Rabban.
That's the bull of Alamigo.
My friends, You are not alone in your anger, your grief, your despair. For it is mine as well.
Yeah, let's kill the bitch.
That gnawing pain in your breast. It is enough to bring an old bull to his knees. But I ask you, brothers and sisters, to think not only of the family and friends who were cut down before your very eyes, but to think also of the ones who were abducted, the ones who may yet live.
It's true.
Where were they taken? What became of them? These questions demand answers.
That's good. That's a good idea. Good job, Raban.
I share your thirst for justice, for vengeance, but we will gain only fleeting satisfaction if we give in to our base appetites. We will never know the truth.
Yeah, we gotta torture her first.
Now is the time that we, the people of Alamigo, must decide what manner of nation we will build for ourselves and for generations yet unborn. When they look to our example, will they see a people who held fast to their principles, or one who cast them aside when tried? I say to you, it is our responsibility to give these prisoners a fair trial, that they might answer to all of Alamigo. The Galleons called us savages, and I'll be damned if we prove them right.
Yeah.
Yeah! Yeah! Woo! Yeah! Yeah! Woo!
I know you're right. Yeah. I do. But I can't.
Don't you hear the yes?
Yeah! Woo!
Yeah. Yes. We did it. We calmed the crowd thanks to Raban. If he wasn't here, we'd be fucked.
My thanks, Raban. Listening to their anger, I could feel myself being swept away.
It's a difficult tide to stem. It was that same rage that which brought us to our feet and carried us to victory. But now the war is over, all the unspent fury is being channeled into vengeance.
Aye, and it's not just just here. We have reports of mobs forming all over. They've been targeting folk known to have cooperated with the Galleons. It starts with insults most often, but then someone picks up a stone. Some industrious souls even thought to speak out the graves of Xenos and his officers. It was grim. I want to build a country where everyone, regardless of race or origin, can live side by side in peace. Mayhap the time isn't right. Mayhap people just aren't ready.
I mean, they were tortured and shit.
It doesn't mean I'm going to try. I'm not going to try. The representatives will be here soon. I'll be damned if I'm going to give up before I've even begun.
Who are these representatives exactly?
Oh, village elders, refugee leaders, and the like. It wouldn't be right of us to dictate the nation's future on our own. We've planned a summit, of course. We've even invited Nanta and the Kikirin to participate.
Alamigo stands at a crossroads, and this meeting will decide which path it takes. The matter of Fodola's sentence cannot be suffered to disrupt proceedings.
Let me execute her and be done with it. She's asked herself to be put to the death. Nago, I already explained why we wouldn't do that. Sending her to the gallows might satisfy people right now, but where would it end? Should we round up everyone who collaborated and everyone who didn't resist? There would be no one left, and we'd be no better than Theodric and Xenos.
True. It's true. Begging your pardon, but might I be allowed to speak with Fodola?
I caught a glimpse of her past, a moment of it anyway, during the fight. She's done terrible things, unforgivable things. But, in some ways, she's a victim of the circumstances in which she was born. That's something I can't understand. Alright, speak with the prison guard when you're ready, and I'll come and join you. I want to talk to her, too.
I'll attend to my other duties, then. We've barely begun to investigate the facility where they gave Wardella her powers. Be fairly warned, friends. She will test you. Don't let your emotions color your judgment when she's done.
Yes, sir. Prison guard.
You're the kind of commander's position to enter then?
Yes, sir.
Let's talk to the bitch. This motherfucker. Almost killed Alize.
So many visitors. Come to have a good laugh, have you?
Yep. You are an embarrassment.
Or do you mean to put me out of my misery? To finish what you started? It's about bloody time.
Nah, we're gonna make you suffer.
That's not why we're here, no.
You deserve to suffer.
Do you remember what I said? How I promised you you'd live long enough to see us win our freedom? Well, I meant it. And not to mock you, either.
You're wasting your time. All of this is pointless! There's no reason to keep me alive, and you know it!
Says you.
I killed your men. I killed my men! And you know what my only regret is? That I didn't kill you when I had the chance!
Bro, like you could.
That's a lie, and you know it! You think we can't tell what you're trying to do? That we're blind? Now, you're a fool, but you're not stupid. You're ruthless. Relentless. You'd give up anything and everything to get what you want. You didn't come this far, climbing over the bodies of your own brothers and sisters just to piss it all away.
It's true.
I see you, Fedora. I see you for what you are.
I see it too now. I'm having the visions. I have the visions.
Fedora, we mustn't be late. The Imperial Viceroy will be attending today's banquet.
Oh.
All right.
Go, Fedora, go.
Father, what's Logaius like? Is he nice? Are you friends?
There you go again with all your questions. Lord Gaius is a great and honorable man who looks after all of Alamigo. He's very busy, and if we don't hurry, we'll miss our chance to see him.
So she was, like, groomed into liking the Empire then. Which makes sense. So it's not her fault that her parents were on the side of the Garleans.
Filthy tinhead lovers.
Father, what did that man call us?
The little tinhead lover doesn't know what she is, eh? A traitor, sweetheart. A backstabbing bitch who gladly betray her kith and kin to gnaw on what few scraps the Imperials deign to toss her. Like your bastard father and whore mother.
It's true. Garleans are terrible.
True. My parents are good people. They've never done anything like that.
Or they have.
Oh, but they were quick to help themselves and their bitch spawn, weren't they? You're just as guilty as them.
Ah, you missed. We were through that rock, missed. Old woman. You missed again.
Traitors!
I mean, I can see why Fordola hates these people. I can easily see it.
Please, you have to do something. My husband and daughter are in danger.
Soldiers of the Imperial Army are under no obligation to intervene in the disputes of Arn.
We're citizens. We have rights.
Ah!
I'm scared.
It's all right. It's all right. They don't understand, but they'll see in time. They'll see that this is the only way to survive. Traitors! Traitors!
They got crazy eyes. Oh, right in the head. He dead? He just died? Holy shit!
Let the savages have their fun. They'll be more compliant once they've tired themselves out.
God damn. God damn.
Fadola, please. You already have citizenship. Why would you want to become a soldier? Oh, gods. What have you done to your face?
Yes.
Forgotten it already, have you? I'm honoring father's memory.
By telling the world that you know better than a common savage.
Am I though, mother? Are any of us?
True.
Can't you see? Citizenship means nothing to them. If you're not a pureblood Garleon, you're no different from any other savage. So I'll play the part. I'll join the Legion and I'll make them respect me. And when the mob see that, they'll think twice before throwing their stones.
Yikes.
Ansfrid, Rudolph, Emlyn. It's time. It'll be hard. Humiliating. They'll try to break us, send us crawling back to our own kind, but we won't, no matter what. We'll bleed for them, die for them if we have to. We'll do whatever it takes to be free!
They're all dead now, except for Fordola. They're all dead.
So, you mean to play the part one last time, eh?
the unrepentant traitor whose death will serve to unite the people.
Shut up.
You had every chance to kill yourself. Fashion a noose from your clothes. Wait for the guards to leave you alone long enough to slip it over your neck.
I said shut up!
No.
But then it would have all been for nothing, wouldn't it? Whatever it takes. That's what you said.
Don't look at me.
Been in my head, have you? Had a little peek at my past.
Yeah, but don't look at me. I'm not on your side.
And what? A few stolen memories tell you everything you need to know, do they? Don't you dare patronize me! You don't know a god's damned thing about the life I've led!
But what if?
The bastards that killed him. The bastards that let it happen. My father deserved better! I swore I'd do whatever it took to make them pay!
Oh my god! Her Sharingan! Her Sharingan! Oh, she's seeing our lives. Oh! That's crazy.
You! All that power, all that pain, it's too much. Too much for anyone.
Nah, dude, I'm a god. I deal with it.
The things they've done to you, the lies, the betrayal, the endless fighting. Yet there you stand, unbroken. How? Why?
Because I don't know when to quit. You know why? You saw. For those I've lost, for those who I can yet save, because I choose to. For those that I've lost, for all the people that I've lost. Harshafan, Papalimo, Mundrida, I do it for Minfilia. We do it for them.
Damn you all.
We do it for them.
You still have time, Fordola. Think about how you want to spend it. Let's go.
We learned a new thing. The measure of our reach. Yay. Echoes of an echo.
I don't know that we solved anything yet, but we've given Fordola something to think about at least.
Aye, and I've found something new to think about too. I don't know about you, Bella, but the visions only come to me every now and then. And the way Fordola kept wincing, though, I get the feeling she's having them almost all the time. A lot of bad memories to deal with. I'm just looking at his back. I'm inside of his back!
Hmm? Oh, I wonder. Would there be some fundamental difference between one who is born with the Echo and one who has been artificially imbued with it? Well, the Immortal Flames have been scouring that research facility ever since deliberation. There's a chance they might have some answers for us. General Alden is over there overseeing the investigation. Let's go and pay him a visit, shall we?
Let's do it.
General Alden. General Alden. And have you found answers as to why? She can see what I see more than what I see when the seeing of the seas. Restoration Nim Guard. Alden is inside, eh? Will you join them? Yes, sir. General Alden. What news? You spoke with Fodola, I take it.
Yes, as expected, she didn't say very much, but it wasn't a total waste of time. Arnvald noticed something odd about her. Thinks she might have been having visions almost constantly, which is not how the Echo normally works. Have you found anything here which might explain why it's so different for her?
We've been hard-pressed just to organize the research materials, let alone study them. To be frank, I'd welcome the Sans' expert assistance. If you have any time to lend a hand. I got you, buddy boy. We're going over here to the Flame Investigator.
So many bodies, every one of them a victim of these experiments. Very, very few signs of external injury. From what I've been able to determine, they perished from forcible aether extraction. Such a miserable way to die.
That's a lot of bodies. Oh, and they're over there. Oh my god, they're all the way over there, dude. That's just a handful of bodies. Oh, they're over on this side too. Holy shit, they're literally everywhere. Like, you cannot walk around without stepping on one. Holy shit, they're literally everywhere.
Yeah.
Magitech pod investigation.
Investigating.
The device in which Kryle was held seems even more ominous now that you know its purpose. The surrounding pods are marked Supply Subject, while this one bears the label Master Subject. Ironworks received a request from the Alliance to analyze these devices, and I have been recording everything of interest. Did you notice the labeling? All the pods were designed to drain the aether out of the occupant, save that one right here, right there. Unlike the others, the Inheritor been fitted with an array of sensors to measure etheric waveforms. What purpose, however, I couldn't tell you.
Interesting.
I know little and less of science, so any light you can shed on the facility's operations would be much appreciated. Bella, shall we start with you?
Yeah, I found some shit, dude.
Taken in combination with the testimonies of Kryle and Thancred, I do begin to see exactly what the Imperials were attempting here. Enhancement procedure entails infusing a single candidate with aether siphoned from a multitude of supply subjects. As for the master subject, in this case Kryle, the patterns of her etheric activity would provide the model upon which they would artificially engineer the candidate's aura. In other words, they were trying to recreate Kryle's echo. I believe so, which would explain our prisoner's present state. Kryle is possessed with an unrivaled ability to hear the whispers of the soul, and it seems probable that the procedure engendered the same acute sensitivity in Fordola. Soldiers who guard Fortola, many of them lost friends and family to the Skulls, and there's a sentry at her door, night and day, if she can't help sensing their thoughts and seeing their past.
She's being constantly tormented every second.
But you don't see their past, you live it. All the emotions, all the pain. Imagine what it would do to you. You'd never be the same again. Indeed. As you may recall, Isael was completely transformed by a single glimpse of Raceveldger's past. Fordola has been forced to experience the agony of those whose lives she has destroyed. The guilt must be unbearable. That explains her request to be executed.
Sounds to me like a kind of justice. Regardless, she can suffer on for now. We have more pressing matters to consider. The results of these experiments have been relayed back to Garlemald. There will be not to stop the Empire from repeating the trick. They could give the echo to anyone, to an entire legion. We must be ready. We must learn all we can of these godforsaken procedures, and Fordola remains our best source of information. She'll not be getting her wish, not yet.
Right.
Keep faith, lass. If you're to convince others to follow you, you must believe what you're telling them. People will respond to passion, but not if it's feigned.
I understand. Thank you, General. We should leave the flames to it. Let's go. I go on looking for answers about the Echo and end up getting schooled by Raban. Yet more evidence that I don't know what I'm doing. It's no wonder people listen to him and not me. General Alden is a veteran of countless campaigns, Lees. You cannot compare yourself to a commander of his experience. I know, but I also know I couldn't have convinced that mob to give up and go home. It makes me realize how much we rely on his authority and how much I still have to learn.
I wonder what it'll do when everything here is settled. I mean, it's his homeland. Going to the trouble of winning it back, might he not want to stay?
Here's a quandary which countless refugees now face. To continue the life they built in Uldah, or to start again in the land of their birth.
Brew.
Bella, a moment.
Pippin.
I'm newly returned from Uldah with a message from the Sultana. Her Grace desires an audience with you. She understands that you have responsibilities here, but asks that you visit the palace at your earliest convenience. Well, I must be away and attend to other business. Until next time, my friends.
Bye, Pippin.
Bye, Pippin.
An audience with the Sultana? Depends on the nature of her consultation. It might be a perfect opportunity to inquire about the General's future plans. Yes, I'd like to know about those too, Alpha now, but not everyone's as comfortable in interrogating royalty as you. Take no notice of him, Bella.
Let's go talk to the Sultana. Okay, in reality, we're going to use my boy. Sultana's strings.
Though the question of how to put the Mad King's treasures to good use shows no sign of answering itself. Shall I be about it, Arnvald?
I'm at your beck and call.
And I should be getting back to my own tasks. I'll organize a squad to head down into the ruins, and then start preparing for the big meeting. Oh, send an animal my regards, Bella. And ours too, if you please. We shall see you on your turn.
Boy, oh yeah, so last thing that happened was the Sultana was just like, hey, I want to talk to you. It's been a bit. We're gonna go have a meeting. And so, yeah, now we gotta go to Uldah. Not Kugane. Wrong button. And we have to go to Uldah and talk to Nanamo on Nanamo. Nanamo Unamo. Nanamo. Through the Chamber of Rule. Nanamamano. Where are you at, Nanamamano? Roloff Shield Smash. What a fucking name.
You're expected, my lady. Please proceed.
Yes, of course I'm expected. Yes, I'm in a meeting, yes.
Nanamo, last time we talked around a table like this, you were killed. Theoretically.
I thank you for answering my summons in these most interesting times. You have been busy.
Yes, I have.
The liberation of Alamigo will have far-reaching consequences, and there is a matter upon which I would seek your counsel.
What is that?
I speak of Rauban and his future.
Rauban.
All know the tale of his rise from penniless refugee to member of the Syndicate and general of the Immortal Flames. Yet though he has come to call Uldar home, it will never be his homeland. He is a son of Alamigo.
Yes.
And now that she is free, I thought it only a matter of time before he sought my leave to return to her. Indeed, I had resigned myself to his loss. Suffice it to say, I was greatly surprised to hear him speak so lightly of handing over the reins in Alamigo and retaking his place at my side.
Oh, yeah?
I will welcome him with open arms, of course. He is my most trusted advisor and my dearest friend. But I have known the man a long time, and beneath that steely gaze, I spied a flicker of doubt.
Our boy Rauban.
Whether Rauban chooses to remain in Uldar or return to Alamigo, I only wish that he do so with a heart unburdened by guilt or regret. Yet how can he freely make such a choice, knowing how much I depend on him? It is past time that I learned to discharge my duties as a Sultana alone. I must go forth and see my realm with my own eyes, and hear the wind with my own ears.
Good on you, Nanamo Olamo.
Might I have your company for a brief adventure?
Yeah, we're gonna go run around the city. Yeah, baby.
Wonderful. Allow me a moment to change into something a touch less conspicuous, and I will join you outside.
Let's do it. Through the quicksand. We must talk to Namo Namama now. Namama Namo Namama no. The Adventurers Guild, yes. Hello, Namama, Nama Umama, no.
Perchance you remember Lyria, Lilira, the merchant's daughter? This is the persona I assume when I venture beyond the palace walls to observe my subjects unnoticed. Ordinarily, Papa Sean would accompany me, but for this particular outing, I need an advisor, not a minder. And that is why I requested your company. Over the course of your many adventures, you have met people from all walks of life, in every corner of Eorzea. I would make use of your worldly experience. Now let's be on our way. Our first destination is Stone's Throat, just beyond the Negate of Nald.
Nald. Stone Throw. Stone Throw. Right out here. Tap, 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 tap. Namo!
Look upon this process of tattered tents. These refugees camp in squalor, at the mercy of the elements and Thanalan's predators both. The city's mighty walls offer safety, but the streets overflow with people as it is. And unless blessed by the land of Nald himself, no refugee could ever hope to afford a dwelling in Uldar. 20 years have passed since the fall of Alamigo, and 5 since the calamity. The plight of the poor has grown more desperate, not less. As Sultana, the blame falls upon me.
But my grace, you've done your best. You've tried really hard.
My best has not been good enough. To press on, I would follow the road to unholy air.
Okay, nah, mama, no. If you say so, umamanamanamamamano. We fly. Meow. Where'd she go? There she is. That Mama Hama no.
It was here, in this unholy, in this woolly, unremarkable place, that my mother and father met their doom. I was but a child at the time. My parents were returning from an inspection of our interests in Eastern Thanland when an untimely rock slide crushed their carriage. To this day, it is not certain if the incident was simply simple misfortune or an expertly planned assassination. Rob Bond offered to reopen the investigation and bring me the truth he assumed I must surely crave, but I refused. Even if my parents' deaths were orchestrated by the Monetarists, we could only have brought their hirelings to justice. The true villains, who plotted to put me on the throne as a biddable puppet, were ever beyond our reach. Thus did I plan to strip the merchants of their power and place our nation in the hands of the citizens, quite unaware of the consequences my actions would have for you and yours. I shudder to think how many goodly souls paid the price of my naivety. But I am no longer a child reciting words with witless obedience. I will not be used as a pawn in the Monetarist's damnable games. I give my outburst. You are one of the few people to whom I feel I can speak my mind. Come, let's return to Uldah and visit the Colosseum.
Yes, ma'am. To Uldur. To Uldur. Off we go. I should probably just teleport, to be honest. Bop. Bop, 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 bop.
The moment I became Sultana, I found myself thrust into an endless parade of document signings and ceremonies. For years, I simply signed where I was told to sign and sat where I was told to sit, blissfully oblivious to what any of it meant. Yet one good thing did come from the anonymous chapter in my life, for it was during an official visit to the Colosseum that I first met Rabban. The match I had been invited to attend was not at all what I expected. They pitted the Bull of Alamigo against some dozen or so rival gladiators. Blinkered though I was, I would not stand so obvious an injustice, and demanded to see a fair fight, one man against another, and my royal wish was duly granted. It was not until later that I learned the gambling ring which had arranged for Rabban to die on sands that day. Regardless, my intervention meant that Rabban had but a single opponent to dispatch, which he duly did. And when he knelt before me to receive the winner's purse, he swore that he would one day offer me his blade in service. Surrounded by liars and manipulators, I confess I dismissed it as a pleasant piece of theater. But as you know, Rabban is a man of his word. Though it took him another 5 years of fighting on the blood sands, he amassed a fortune so great as to buy not only his freedom, but a seat on the syndicate. And then I had my blade.
Aww. Rabban, look at that, two hands. Get fucked. Nice. Look at him. Look at the mad lad himself.
Your Grace, you mustn't! The danger is too great! Please, Your Grace, come back! I beg of you!
Look at her waddle.
It seems you're the one who needs looking after, Master Shum. Rabban!
Your Grace.
Aww.
I have kept the promise made.
Aww.
So you have. And in turn, so too shall I keep mine. With your winnings, you have become one of the six most wealthy souls in all Uldah. And so, as tradition dictates, Rauben Alden, you have earned yourself a seat on the Syndicate. May your new station garner you still greater glories.
I am honored, Your Grace, and vow to serve with every fiber of my being from this day till my last.
Aww. She's so happy.
Long live the Sultana, and long live Uldah!
She's so happy. Aww. That was a good cutscene.
I cannot well express what that man means to me. There are others who care deeply for my well-being, of course. Papa Sean's love for me is as that of a grandsire for his grandchild. But upon matters of governance, I cannot turn to bodyguards and maidservants for counsel. Rabban, with the authority of his syndicate position, was the first sword I could wield. His was the only edge which could cut the strings that bound me.
Aww. Sultana's duty.
We must make haste. My absence will not go unnoticed by the Sultana's Sultansworn for long, and there are other places I would visit. To the Azanath Ossuary.
There we go. Where is that? Oh, it's the Black Mage area. Okay. This is right out here. Namana Hamano.
When the calamity threatened, Rabban led the Alliance forces into battle on the plains of Kartanau, and I remained here. I prayed with all my heart that Archon Louis Woe would have the power to rouse the 12. Since that day, I have made a custom of visiting this shrine during each of my little exertions. Here I seek the blessing of Thal, reflect upon my choices, and ask myself if I am fulfilling my duties as a Sultana. You are rightly celebrated as a champion because you have led the line in 100 battles for the good of Eorzea. In much of the same, I believe the measure of a monarch lies in how she leads her people in times of adversity. If I'm to be a Sultana worthy of the name, I cannot turn a blind eye to the troubles facing Uldah. I've chosen my path, Bella. With Alamigo now freed from Imperial chains, I finally see a way to aid the refugees. Already, many dispatched Alamigans seek to begin their long trek home. To facilitate that process, I have made a small contribution. Arson's school in Ralgar's Reach for any who wish to learn new trades. Realistically, however, it will take years for such training to yield tangible benefits. We do not have years. These people will need shelter and employment if they are to survive. And this time, the Uldah Treasury shall provide. Precisely where and how to allocate the necessary funds is, of course, another question. I asked a member of the syndicate for advice. Why not seek the advice of one of your employees, refugees? Why not ask for the syndicate for advice? A wise suggestion. We have a visit to the Gold Saucers in order. Its proprietor is a member of the syndicate, and he is one of the few who pay refugees a fair wage. I wonder, are you acquainted with Godbert Manderville?
Yes. Godbert Manderville.
Oh, well, he is a most generous man. If something of an eccentric, let us make our way to the landing. I will see that word is sent to the gold saucer. Godfrey should be only too glad to receive us.
Dude, are we gonna go see Godbert Mandeville, man? The god himself?
We better go meet God. To the landing. I've ridden aboard a public airship before, but this shall be my first visit to the saucer. I must confess it's to some excitement.
Let's do it, dude. Take me to the gold saucer. The Manderville gold saucer, yes. Where is our girl Namahamano? Namahamano. Actually, before we talk to Namahamano, we gotta check our gold saucer tickets. I never even thought about that. Tis be the time. Which fucking location is it? I forget. But it's one of these. I think it's up here. Shoot. We need to go to the one above us. There we go. Hey, we should check our thing. Ticket. Cashier lady. What did I win? I got a consolation prize. Get out of the way. And then the numbers match, so I have got money. Was the ring number was 8695. What is this? Oh, it's a ring. Yes, level 1 constellation. Oh. So we got level 7 because of how many tickets were sold, so I got 1100 for participating. Sorry, I got 12. I forgot we put 2 in. We put 2 in, so we got 2200, which isn't bad. Let's go purchase another ticket. 1, 2, 3, 4. 2, 5, 9, 8. Another one. Let's do 5 if possible. 9, 7, 6, 5, and 2. No, we can only do 3. Okay, we did 3. Anyways, back to the Namahamano. Mamahanamo. Give me a quick second. This is very important. Very, very important. Sorry, very, very important things. But now we're here to talk to Namahamano. Mamahanamano.
I had heard descriptions of its splendor, yet I have never dreamed it would be so bright and inviting. No. I couldn't possibly. We did not come here to fritter away the royal coin. Godbert will be expecting us. Come, let us head directly to the lounge and ignore these gaudy temptations.
If you say so, Mahamama, no. So she's upstairs, yeah. Up we go. Nah, mama, no. He's Godbert himself. Yes.
I believe this is where we are to meet Lord Mandeville. Shall we sit while we wait his coming?
My lord! My apologies, your grace. I've kept you waiting.
No apologies are necessary, Godbert. My request was sudden, and you were kind to make yourself available at such a short notice.
When the Sultana herself comes calling, there is no more important engagement.
As to the purpose of my visit, I would have your thoughts on how the crown might best aid the refugees residing in Thanalan. You are aware, I am sure, that many of Alamigo's displaced sons and daughters long to return to their newly liberated homeland, and you are also aware that they will suffer without shelter and work to sustain them. I would use our nation's wealth to spare them that suffering. What advice have you for me on the matter of how it might best be distributed?
Ah, boy. The usual circumstances of your meeting and your grace's choice of companion would suggest me a desire for an honest and unvarnished opinion. I shall give you one. My advice to you is stop. Taxing Uldar's wealth to save Alamegan refugees is a terrible, terrible idea.
You oppose my proposition?
Most emphatically. I agree with your grace that the refugees must have housing and employment. But what profit is there for Uldar in this arrangement? Good point.
Profit? Are you... after all you've done... you have done for Girabania's displacement, I thought you the very last person to seek benefit from their misfortune.
Forgive me, your grace, but you appear to be laboring under a misapprehension. It is a fine endeavor to support one's fellow man. I fear, however, that your stance is one born of pity. Your intent is to save the refugees, is it not?
It's true. They don't need saving, they were just saved. What they need is help, not to be saved.
For all our potential, we are indolent creatures by nature. If unconditional charity is all we know, then we begin to rely upon it, to expect it. And then we must consider Uldar's poor and downtrodden. Should they hear of you spending the nation's coin, not to improve their lots, but to nurture the distant citizens of Alamigo, it is likely that they will applaud your generosity. Is it not your grace's intention to foster newer resentments, but to spread goodwill?
Indeed. Then any support I pledge to the refugees must promote self-sufficiency whilst also serving the interests of the people of Uldar.
Exactly so. Such an arrangement will create a far more equitable relationship with the returning Almegans, even as it generates the revenue required to win the approval of your subjects.
Makes sense.
You have given me much to ponder, Lord Mandeville. I thank you for your candor.
Yeah. Miles.
Bum, 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 bum.
We did the Sultana's duty. Namahamano. Sultana's revolt.